also just yesterday about my Sparkles of Joy book, which is about Diwali, Hanukkah and Christmas. And my questions to parents is, have you ever wondered why Diwali and Deepavali, both are words used for Diwali? Have you ever wondered why Diwali is celebrated so largely around the world? If you answer yes, these books are for you. If you answer no, you need these books even more. Because these are questions that you need to be asking yourself about why in Hindi we say Hamari Tumhari Hum Sabki Diwali. So it's like yours and mine, Diwali belongs to all of us. So why do we say that? And this book explains that in context to Christmas and Hanukkah as well.
Yeah, and that was so neat. I wanted to talk especially about Sparkles of Joy just because we are coming up on that time. It's so cool because one, and it does a really great job of explaining Diwali, but it's in the context of friends who are asking questions and then finding similarities with things that they do. Like one of them was like, oh yeah, I like sparklers and firecrackers. We do that on 4th of July. Or, oh, that reminds me of doing what we do for Hanukkah or Christmas. So these are really kids learning from each other and learning how to be respectful, and they're finding similarities. And I think, that was one of the things that's so beautiful, that people can use this as a way of explaining the holidays, but also like modeling for children how we can, like you said, how to be empathetic.
I certainly hope so, because this book is also my hope that children are more open about discussing about their culture in a positive way. My son has, touch wood, a lot of friends from different cultures, and they come home just like this play date, even like one at a time, or maybe a couple of, or whatever. During COVID it was one at a time, but before it was just we like all of them. And it was always interesting to hear the conversations around culture. Either it's super full of pride that, oh, my culture has this, or it's, you know, kind of looking down upon your own self or looking down on others. And I really hope that children understand that when you're talking about your culture or something that you pride in your culture, doesn't mean that you need to look down on someone else's thing. And I think as adults, sometimes we do that very subtly, not realizing that the children are watching and the children imbibe that. And that is why this book, in fact, when I was writing this book, I had reached out to someone, an editor, and she said, no, you should not have the book like this. You should have it like this. You should have something. And I said, but I want the children to be having the conversation, because children do ask these questions. You know, why do you do this? Why do you do that? Why does this happen? Oh, you know, you are doing this. Even I do this. You know, it's something so... Kids do it all the time. They constantly compare. Hell, adults also compare all the time. So I wanted it to be that conversation where the kids are realizing themselves that, oh, I like Diwali. I like lighting candles. And my house sparkles because I grew up with neighbors who were Christians. And every as soon as Diwali would get over, their Christmas tree would be up.